hello and welcome to the TerraPura non-league show. Today's show we're bringing to you from Culver Road, the home of Sussex FA, and today the home of Lancing FC as they take on Horsham YMCA in the Southern Combination League. Now these two teams have sort of followed each other over the last couple of seasons. Two seasons ago, Lancing were pushing for promotion, finishing fourth. Horsham YMCA finished seventh, both with a high points tally. Last season they both finished in mid-table and they'll be looking to push on back to those promotion chasing places in this season. Lancing's season in the league hasn't started too well, only 1 point from their opening two games. Horsham YMCA served a thrashing on the opening day of season away to Pagham, who do score a lot of goals as we've seen on the non-league show, but they've got 3 points following a victory in their previous game. Both teams scored a lot of goals in the Peter Bentley Cup second round in midweek. Lancing with 4 goals here and with Horsham YMCA getting a 5-0 thrashing over Worthing United. So hopefully there'll be plenty of goals in today's game. We'll find out, of course, later on. So I'm here with Jan. It's her second game. She's a new Lancing fan, new to the game. You're enjoying yourself so far?
Yeah, brilliant. Excellent.
And what encouraged you to start coming down here to Culver Road?
My husband. I'm fed up sitting at home on my own. So I thought, I can't beat them, join them. And I've thoroughly enjoyed it. I've only been once, my second time today. So I'm impressed. Everybody's so nice, you know, and you've only got to ask a question and you answer, nobody ignores you, and I shout.
Oh, we've got to watch out for that.
Yeah.
Nothing rude, I hope.
No.
No, no, no.
Yeah, no, I've thoroughly enjoyed it. It's something I've never done. Ron's always the sporty one, the golf, and I was always sitting doors. And now I'm not. It's lovely.
And have you started to learn any particular players, anyone to look out for?
I know if I've seen the young lads.
Only young ones, under 21.
So you've got your eye on the under 21s?
Well, everybody, I mean, all of them are very promising, to be quite honest. You get used to one and you check on one, don't you? You seem to pick one out. And I don't know his name, but wow, can he run? It's really, I think it's the fastest one I've seen on here, run like hell, but I don't know his name. and I think, God, look at that. Come on, boy. You know, and you're sitting there and you're actually getting, I'm getting better at it, you know, understanding it. Know what he's going to do, you know, and yes, I'm very impressed because it's a fantastic little team.
Lancing Football Club were formed in 1946. We've been here in the community ever since then. We've been in the County League all that time. We had a Southern Combination. Our aim eventually would be to try and get to Ryman level, but we don't really have the wherewithal, we don't have the funding, and it's as simple as that. But that would be our aim at the end of the day. We ground share with the FA here, of course, which does bring its own inherent problems, as you know. But apart from that, yeah, we're a nice, close community. We've got a very good squad. They're a very team-minded squad, and we don't pay any money. So unfortunately, we can't compete with the Haven teams and, you know, the other teams in the league who have got aspirations to go up to the Rhinelands. As simple as that, basically.
But one of the good things that I've noticed is that your squad remains pretty consistent year on year out, which a lot of these clubs that do play money, that isn't the case.
Absolutely, yeah. We're very, very lucky. We have a very strong player base and they are loyal. They've had offers to go elsewhere. Some of them have been elsewhere, tasted it and come back to good old Lancing. Facilities here are second to none and we do try and look after them and do the best we can. So we are very lucky in that respect.
Here we are then, as the two teams make their way out onto the pitch. Let's run through the two lineups. We'll start with Lancing at home, of course, wearing their yellow shirts, blue shorts and yellow socks. And they make 4 changes from the midweek Peter Bentley Cup win against Selling, a 4-3 win. Out goes Clayman, B. Donaldson, Marsh and Aguirre. And coming in their place is Emery, Broughton, Spinks and Drummis. So let's run through the full lineup for you. In goal number 1, Tyler De Cruz. Number 2, Tom Emery. Number 3, Lewis Broughton. Number 4, Elliot Finney. Number 5, Lewis Pittock. Number 6, Alex Spinks. Number 7, Luke Donaldson. Number 8, Mike Williamson. Number 9, Alex Fair. Number 10, Leon Drummis. And number 11, Lewis Finney. And for Horsham, will they make just the one change from their 5-0 win over Worthing United in the week, and that's Luke Gedling coming in for Joe Shelley. So the full lineup for the visitors wearing all red. It's Aaron Gill, number one, number two, Dean Carden, number three, Dan Evans, number four, Tom Gilbert, number five, Charlie Cook, number six, Luke Gedling, number seven, Brad Curtis, number eight, Liam Humphreys, number nine, Sam Scharf, number 10, Phil Johnson, and number 11, Dave Brown. And the substitutes for Lancing are Brad Donaldson, George Bunch, Ricky Aguirre, Matt Blogg, and Lucas Trodria. And the subs for Horsham YMCA, Joe Shelley, Ash Dugdale, Guy Harding, Ollie Gill, and Ben Godfrey. The referee today is Daniel Durso, with assistants Andy Simmons and Angela Bennett. Referee just checking. In fact, the away bench seems to be the issue. Sitting down by the, rather than using the bench, sitting down by the side of the pitch. The assistant referees just making sure they're in the required zone. How very non-league football. Manager, of course, Peter Buckland for Horsham YMCA. And it will be Donaldson getting us underway. On the way back to Spinks, who immediately puts the ball out, headed away early in the channel. Time now in the middle of the park. It's just set back to Cook. He comes across to his fullback, Dean Garden. He can play one forward, a little flick round. Picked and held up. Good strong play from Phil Johnson at the top. A little ball over the top into Cruz. Makes the early claim. So Culver Road's been home in Lancing for many years. They share this ground with the Sussex FA, as mentioned earlier. They also having to contend with sharing with Horsham, the other Horsham in the league, playing this in while they build their new ground. Spinks. There's slight frustration for Donaldson. The ball didn't have enough on it. Humphreys. Now it does come out to Curtis. Comes back to his fullback. Another ball over the top looking for Scharf. And he does bring it down really well. Looking for some support. Scharf, good quick feet from him. Then comes inside, takes on, beats one. And a second, not the third. And a break could be on here, because Finney's got loads of space. He has to check back, receives the ball. Spinks, and now Finney working the ball between them. A slight miscommunication between Finney and Donaldson will allow Horsham YMCA to bring the ball away. And he could go all the way through here. The defence stepped up, thinking it was going to be offside. And here's a chance for Brownie. Rouse the keeper, it's got to be. The opening goal of the game, Dave Brown. 1-0 for Horsham YMCA. The Lancing defence stepped up, expecting the ball to be played through. And Dave Brown to step through them. And it's the simplest of goals. He did well to fool the goalkeeper. But he's tapped it in the back of the net. And just over 6 minutes played. It's Lancing 0, Horsham YMCA 1. Good battle there between Dramis and the fullback Emery. Emery lofts that one forward. Schaff appeared that he might have been offside when that ball played, but he's done really well there. And Schaff for two, and Schaff curls it in for two, and 11 minutes gone. It's an absolute disaster start for Lancing. Again, a simple ball over the top, this time from the fullback Emery. It appeared Schaff was offside at first, but he did well to bring the ball under control, held up the ball and then curled it past the keeper from the edge of the area. John Sharman will be kicking himself this start. In a very flat atmosphere inside Culver Road, as you'd expect. The visiting team 2-0 up early on. A ball over chase for Johnson to chase. And he wins a corner off of Finney. Well claimed by De Cruz. So in Schaff's 100th appearance for the club, he's got his 47th goal. It's Lancing break here. Williamson plays a nice one too. Finney just rolls behind him though. Lancing pick up possession. Nice little turn play there from Broughton. He's looking for the return from Fair. here is fair. He's got a man coming. Plays it inside of Finney. He's got acres of space here. He elected to carry the move on. Here's Dramis. Gets across in, headed towards goal. Into the keeper's arms. Fair now stands over this. It's been waved away by Dramis. Five yellow shirts in and around there, easily headed away. Chases on to keep the ball in play. Pittick lets that run out and then gets on with the game again very quickly. I'm not sure he meant it, but Finney gets in, crossing. A real chance, it's got to be, and it is 2-1. A real mix-up at the back, and Donaldson managed to poke it in past the keeper, came off him. And 16 minutes on, it's game on again. It's Lancing 1, Horsham YMCA 2. So Luke Donaldson there, just getting in ahead of his marker. Great cross, I think, from Pittock. So 3 goals in 16 minutes. Good start to the game. And it's George Bunch. So Dramis stands over this free kick. Lots of movement around the edge of the area. And they'd all moved away from where the ball was eventually played. And here's the substitute, George Bunch and Finney, looking for the 1-2. Instead, nice quick feet and a shot, takes a block. Another free kick, and that one is a free kick. Rather theatrical fall. Very much a theatrical fall after the challenge. It was a foul. And now Dean Carden getting into a bit of an altercation with the fan. Absolutely don't need that at any level of football. And not a good example to any of the fans, the attendants or viewers watching this programme tonight on Latest TV. The long and short of it is a yellow card to Mike Williamson. But Lancing certainly grown into this game from a disappointing start.
Come on, you yellow!
Carden up towards Schaff. Schaff with a flick on. Johnson making a nuisance of himself, but well dealt with by Broughton. Carden's forced to go back. He'll get the return though. He's got time to bring this forward. Looks up and there's to Schaff, and Schaff is onside. He takes a touch, but coming across was Williamson. And a hooked cross is dealt with by Emery. Dramis, nice little turn from him. Does well under change of three players, but then it's taken off him by Brown. And here's Schaff. And that's three. And trying to play their own way out at the back. Picked off by Brown, who played in Schaff, who had far too much space in the centre of the goal. And he curled the ball into the corner again past the outstretched leg of Tyler de Cruz, and 25 minutes gone. It's 3-1 to the visiting team. And just when it looked like Lancing were not only getting back into the game, but were looking like making some headway into the scoring, they've been picked off by a defensive error from Dramis trying to dribble his way out. Comes out to Broughton. Here he is again, up to Finney. Williamson and Finney. his bunch. Nice movement from him. Doesn't find Drummis on that far side, and dealt with by Evans. Cook allowed to put the ball forward. It's got to be tight control, and was from Johnson. Here's Carden, who looks straight over the top, and straight over the top again. It's there. It's Johnson. Appeared a little push in the back there. No appeals for a free kick. Broughton and Bunch. Pressure now from Horsham up front. Those front three, we call them, with Schaff, Johnson and Brown, causing the trouble. Good header from Spinks under pressure. And he releases Carden on this near side. Of course, looks long for Schaff. He looks to play the ball around the corner, and the Johnson, surely the flag will go up if he goes for this, but it doesn't. And Broughton deals with it by playing the ball to De Cruz. And Bunch spreads the play the other way. Lots of space now to bring the ball forward a few yards. Again, under hit pass. Brown using his pace and getting beyond. He's just stood up and wrestles to the ground. Interesting. And that's not the first time Brown's kicked the ball away. So, 10 minutes to go until half time. 3-1 lead to the visitors, Horsham YMCA today. Spinks with a chip ball looking for Drummis. He's going to chase it against Evans. And Donaldson picks it up, keeps it in play. And that's a lovely piece of skill from him on the knee. And he gets a cross in. And coming in was Finney. It's Fair. Lovely turn from him. Can he score? Oh, great effort from Fair. Just got underneath it. Took slightly longer than he probably would have wanted, but great turn of feet. Humphreys got time to pick out his pass, and he spreads it out towards Brown, who lost the ball in the sun. Drummis to Donaldson, who is allowed to turn, and Fair plays it through. And coming through now is Drummis. He rounds the keeper. It cleared off the line, and then eventually cleared away, and it hit Spinks. I think he was running in. Finney picked up. The danger's not over yet. Broughton. That's cleared away on the edge. Here's Emery. His ball up. Donaldson's had acres of space there, picking the ball up inside the penalty area. Fair. Lovely reverse pull out to Finney. Finney takes it down on the chest, shoots, and that is a fantastic goal. 3-2, game very much back on. Lovely pass with the outside of the boot by Fair. A beautiful touch of control, and that finish just inside the post. The keeper had absolutely no chance, and Lewis Finney picks up where he left off on Tuesday night and scores another goal. It's Lancing 2, Horsham YMCA 3. De Cruz goes long up to Donaldson, who chests that on, and Spinks just got pipped to it by Dean Carden. Horsham allowed to play at the back, but now under pressure from Donaldson. And Finney coming across. That was easily dealt with. Broughton goes on the outside, but it's held up by Brown and Finney. Him and Bunch, and then Broughton. And Broughton can bring the ball forward here. Running at the defence, spreads the play nicely to Drummis. Coming up in the tension was Evans, but Drummis is still going, and he went for goal. Just didn't quite get the angle right, was always chasing the ball. And we slipped in by Corden. Flicked on by Brown. No one in a red shirt there, though. Dramis will bring this forward. And he guides past another one. He's run a long way and wins a free kick. And that's the third time the ball has been kicked away by a Horsham YMCA player, and that time it was Humphreys. And Humphreys gets a very, very cheap yellow card right at the end of this half. So Dramis pop this one in. The same four yellow shirts running in and around the box. Fair making a run late, easily dealt with. And that's the end of the first half, which has seen five goals, three of which have come from the visitors, who took an early lead courtesy of a goal from Dave Brown, who just literally ran through the defence. Schaff made it two from distance, shooting from the edge of the area. Donaldson pulled one back, a scrappy goal for him, before Schaff got his second from a similar position to the first. And Lewis Finney with a 5-5 finish, making this an interesting second half to come. Half-time score is Lancing 2, Horsham YMCA 3. So back out then ahead of the second half, and it will be Horsham YMCA kicking off this one from right to left as we get the subs off the pitch and the ball boys and whoever else is joined on the pitch for the half-time entertainment. So five goals then in quite an astonishing first half, really, when you think about it. And if that wasn't enough to whet the appetite, Horsham YMCA's win over Worthing United, all five goals were scored in the second half. So there's optimism that there'll be plenty more goals here this afternoon. So an early ball over the top, which Broughton will happily see out. Dramis looked to flick it over the head of Evans. And early injury certainly caught the bottom of the studs of Dan Evans. It's not who ate all the pies, it's who ate all the cakes here at Culver Roads. Half-time Victoria Sponge. And Lewis Finney stands over this one. Looked at Cullen, they've got five men lined up along the edge of the box now. And it's looking initially for the run of Dramis. And that speculative shot from George Bunch harmlessly goes wide. And Curtis looking for support. Carden gets across him with his left foot. Cruz comes out, claims. And that's a high ball. I don't think the kind of pass he's looking for, and Donaldson trying to make something of it, but will be easily dealt with. And the little touch there didn't help Jill, but with only one yellow shirt in attendance, it's easy for Horsham YMCA to play the ball out, which they are doing now with Humphreys up to Schaff. Evans in support, looking over the top, and Johnson is over the top. But that was three passes. But Elliot Finney got a little foot in there. And then Lewis up to Donaldson, who evades that challenge. And still going into the area. He's got support. Instead, he goes for goal at the keeper, down at his near post. A good positive run. And Luke Gedling will be coming off. It's his second spell with the club. And Joe Shelley will be coming on. So the two swap round from their roles in the Peter Bentley Cup win over Worthing United. And his first shot. His first touch for the sub. Curtis just steps inside of Finney and gives the ball away. And Fair just turns into trouble. And the ball forward again for Shaft to chase. Remember, he's on a hat-trick. He goes down, holding his calf, I think. No one in a red shirt appealing. And the referee does stop and ask for treatment. Didn't look like there was too much going on. Does appear to be some concern for Shaft. And, yeah, according... That'll be the end of his game on his 100th appearance. It's certainly not the way he'd like to have gone off as he hops off the pitch. So Ollie Gill, who will be coming on to replace Shaft, is the man. I think we're going to restart with a drop ball before he's allowed to come onto the pitch. And so we have a drop ball and an early chance and a corner. Number 12. And it is aimed towards him, but it doesn't quite reach him. Headed back in by the captain. And then half cleared and then full cleared by Lewis Finney. And Donaldson will chase. And that's a loose header. And Cook will have to get there. And Cook does get there ahead of his keeper. And Donaldson gives up the chase. And it's not the first time he appears to be clutching at his inner thigh, I think. Could be struggling with an injury there, the front man.
Come on, you yellow!
But Gilbert can bring it forward and running off the ball, looking. Curtis will leave this for Cardam. And here's a first touch for Jill. He takes on his man, wins a corner. So Dave Brown. Scorer of the first goal, seems an age ago now, gets the cross in and it's headed towards goal, and it seemed like two Horsham YMCA players got in their own way, and that's an intelligent ball, and Dremis can bring it forward and he's got support. It's played forward to Finney, he's just probably further ahead than he'd like, but he'll keep that in play. Lots of red shirts are back. That ball slightly played too far, but Dremis goes for goal. And it wasn't far away. Not far away at all from Dramis, who played through brilliantly and brought the ball forward. That's avoided the challenge and nearly played in Jill. And De Cruz came out and did just enough. Horsham bench are appealing. I think that De Cruz handled the ball out of this area. I think that's their complaint anyway. That's easy for Cook, who brings it down. Nearly showed a bit too much of it to Finney. Cardin trying to calm things down. He's got Shelley in the middle. And now Jill. He's playing deeper than Shaft was playing earlier. Here's Curtis, who switched sides on the overlap. Fullback Evans. He gets a lovely crossing. There's no one in a red shirt there, and Broughton doesn't get that fully clear. And Shelley with a volley, and that is four. The clearance fell to Shelley on the edge, and he hit it first time into the corner. Nothing the keeper could do. And it's now Lancing 2, Horsham YMCA 4. There's the sad sight of Sam Schaff hobbling his way round to the dressing room. He does look in some discomfort. And throw him back to Jill. Looks long. Spinks forward. And Finney, lovely turn from him. Are we going to see some magic from Finney? Into the keeper's hands, who immediately gets on with the game. He's allowed to bring the ball forward, and here's Curtis. He gets his cross in, and it goes under all the way through to Brown. Saved away at the near post by De Cruz. And Emery, a strong header. Lancing throwing. But Dave Brown, very close. And it's too easy in behind the net. Can they get the cross in? Has to check back. It's got support. And that's a whipping cross, and it's a free header for Shelley. Just couldn't quite direct it on target. Great cross from Carden, whipped in to the six-yard box, the edge of the six-yard box. Bunch up to Aguirre. And Broughton's made a run forward. Yellow shirt's jogging forward in support, but it's had to come all the way back to Bunch. And Spinks is under pressure from Jill. To Finney. To his namesake. And then has to come back. And for the first time in a long time, Lancing have Horsham penned inside their own half. Finney. Took too long and Shelley closed him down. And Jill spots the keeper off his line. And it wasn't far away. So we're into the last couple of minutes. Dugdale has a chance to turn. He picks one through for Jill, and it's almost a three subs combined there. It's a fashion of chance, but Williamson got a very important head. Bunch goes back to Finney. And that's safely out of play. Maintaining possession, seeing the game out. Unfortunately, unlike the Premier League and other divisions, we don't have the big scoreboard telling us how many minutes of stoppage time there are to play. As Cook heads that back to Jill. Humphreys has acres of space to turn and bring it forward, but instead he prods it up towards Dugdale and then Shelley. Shelley, when he gets the ball, looks like he's looking to land a further killer blow, but those blows have long since been landed by Horsham YMCA. Here's Shelley again in the middle, gets past Bunch a little bit easier, then plays a lovely ball to Brown, little step over inside. Here's Shelley over the top. Evans under pressure from Dremis, so he's forced to hook that one back, and Fair allowed Jill and Cook to play a bit of head tennis before Jill then collected and rolled the ball out. Shelley dug out. Shelley has gone on ahead, and Johnson now comes back and slows things down once again. And again, each pass is comfortable. Each pass under not much pressure. And that is the first loose pass in a long while from Shelley, who gets the clearance. And with ease, makes a lovely ball around the corner from Johnson. And he wasn't reading the return. Elliot Finney. Maguire under pressure from Dugdale. Here's Bunch. Broughton looking for options. Williamson just got in there. Gift the ball away though. Is this going to be a fifth? And Brown protects the ball. So much space and time for him. Jill makes the outside run. Instead, oh, lovely fit again for Brown like he did for the first. Good block. Humphreys, Shelley running in. And steaming in, I should say, was Johnson, who barged over the yellow shirt on his way through. Fair, I was going to say, held up the ball well, but then gave the ball away. A little chip forward, and Dugdale has made a run in behind. Just couldn't get the ball under. And Williamson gives the ball away again, and Horsham. Looks like a matter of time before they get a fifth, as Shelley with a little dummy and ran into trouble. Still coming forward is Broughton. Finney. Tremis has got acres of space and sums up Lancing's day somewhat. He got his studs caught in the turf. Brown to Dugdale. And the referee finally puts an end after 6 minutes of injury time. Not quite sure where he got that from. But it's a game that's had many, many goals, most of them in the first half. Horsham YMCA raced into a 3-1 lead at one point when Elliot Finney pulled one back. You thought maybe game on the second half. But in truth, Horsham YMCA controlled the second half. Finally got their deserved fourth. The substitute Joe Shelley volleying in as the ball fell to him on the edge of the area. Final score here then at Culver Road was Lancing 2, Horsham YMCA 4.
I was a bit upset at half-time. I thought we should have controlled the game more, not let him get the two soppy goals. You know, so it's never perfect football, is it? But I felt we're pretty much in control. And in the second half, I insisted on them pushing higher up the pitch, shutting them in the last third. I had the benefit of bringing on three really good players to bring some fresh legs on. And it was clear in the end. I think it was a comfortable 4-2 victory. I'm always a bit, you know, about coming down. This is the only game we play in the entire season on artificial surface. Now, I know a lot of people, you know, make high of that, but it, nonetheless it is, and it always bothers me. We never seem to do that well down here, other than last season when it broke us out down here. But, you know, it's got to be an advantage if you're playing on it and training on it all the time. The lads complaining of hips and ankles and Christ knows what all the time now, so I don't know what that's going to do for Lancing as the season progresses. But having said that, to me, as an onlooker, the ball seems to run pretty true. It seems to bounce pretty true. So, you know, I'm well past the stage of my life where I'll ever be playing on it to know. But all things considered, yeah, early in the season, they're a young, fit side playing on this surface. Got to be pleased with it.
All the right things were said at half time. You know, we spoke about how we wanted to play the second half. But I just don't think we come out. I think the first 10 minutes we were okay. But then they got on top, and when they get on top, they're a good side, and they put sort of, they were comfortable. It was only two goals in it, but they scored the goal and they looked after the ball. And to be honest with you, we couldn't do that the second half, so we didn't really threaten that. Goal,
seemed to be a lot of frustration on the pitch, and the effort dropped. I've not seen that before. Is that? Can you explain why?
I wouldn't say that. I mean, the players out there are all certainly trying. I think it doesn't help when you're missing five centre backs today, and that was clear to see with both our centre midfielders. Normally, we're playing centre backs. You can't legislate for missing, you know, five centre backs. But what we had to deal with it. And I thought, you know, they were knocked back twice in that first half, and they come back. You know, showed they got grit and character and determination, and I think probably it was a bit too far when they got the fourth for us to go again and look to get back in it.
Another thing, just a word on Schaff. Obviously got two goals, his 100th appearance today. Don't know if you knew that. How is he? I mean, we saw him hobbling around the pitch.
Yeah, he'll be out the next game. Yeah, his ankle's really swollen up. It wasn't a bad tackle or anything. He turned it, and it's twice the size it should be. I'll be very surprised if he's fit for the Bridges game. So here we are, like four or five games in, and I've already got four people out injured, you know. Unbelievable. I must have shot a robin at Christmas.
Well, the games roll thick and fast.
Yeah,
obviously,
absolutely.
Monday game, most players should
well,
be fit.
Our bank holiday game is switched to Tuesday night. It's Three Bridges at home. And then next Saturday we haven't got a game. We were due to play Eastbourne Town, but they're still in the FA Cup. So thankfully, actually, I'm glad we haven't got a game. We can get them on the old table and get them fit again.
Attacking-wise, though, it looks promising. So new formation, you were playing Donaldson up front, well, certainly from what I remember from last season.
Yeah.
Donaldson playing and playing Fair and Finney in behind him.
It was just a variation of formation we normally play. We still set up as normal, but we used Fair more attacking-wise, position behind. So we knew we had to score goals today because defensively we were struggling, and we went out and in the first half we created a lot of chances. We scored two, maybe could have had a couple more, and probably just before they scored, I think Luke Donaldson had a good way cut into the box and maybe should have done a bit better. But no, we want to score goals. We want cameras there. We want people through the gates watching us and scoring goals. We'll help that.
Absolutely. And then we go again on Monday.
Yeah, relentless at the moment. Hopefully have a couple of players back, but one or two. Hopefully Chichester away, another tough game. We've been given a really tough start to the season, but you know, we dust ourselves down, we look at where we've gone wrong, and we look to put things right, and we look to learn in defeat. And Chichester will go again, and hopefully we can get some points in for the bank holiday weekend.
So then we have the end of another TerraPura non-league show and another six goals, but unfortunately for Lancing, four of them were in the back of their net. So let's have a look at the scores elsewhere around the leagues. We'll start with the game we actually played yesterday. Worthing were playing their fourth game in a row away from home. Obviously the issues with their ground still to be resolved. Hopefully we'll have some information about that next week. They actually, as Gary Elphick described it, as a very spirited display and like the Worthing of old, but they still lost 3-2, so have lost every game 4 out of 4 so far this season. One team who had also lost 4 out of 4 games of Whitehawk, where they've got their first point of the season. They drew 1-1 at home to Braintree Town, so good result for the Hawks and their first points on the board this season. Carl Shorten Athletic served another lesson to Shoreham, who are finding it difficult in the Bostic League South. They lost 4-1 away at Carl Shorten Athletic today. That is their third straight league defeat. Lewis, we followed them on the non-league show last week. They've drawn 2-2 today at home to Sittingbourne. Pagham, high scorers in their league, were playing Peacehaven and Telscombe. Pagham scored twice. Peacehaven and Telscombe scored 3 goals. 3-2 victory for them, and they only had 10 men. Their goalkeeper was sent off late on in that game. Then a bit of a shock. Burgess Hill Town have opened their league campaign with 3 straight draws. Were drawing level 1-1 at half-time away at Billericay Town before conceding 5 goals and losing that game 6-1. And that is where we're heading to on Monday night. Next Monday night, we'll be at Billericay Town for their game against Worthing, which promises to be an absolute thriller. That's it for now for tonight. We'll see you again next Monday on the TerraPura Non-League Show.